Hey, it's Necktie. Welcome to episode 117 of Road to 5 Million. And in this one, we're taking some PVC pipe to Fort Stockton. And then we're probably going to head over and check out the new property in Pecos. Let's get into it. I'm already loaded. I'm kind of crooked, but whatever. If you remember from the last episode, this is where we delivered. So I'm just using their trailer. And if you did watch the last episode, I am still using the mirror trick, I guess, that you can do in the console. So no real FOV mod or realish FOV mod is what I think I was using. I may have to message Matt. Because those flags are correct leaving this yard. But they should actually be the other way. The American flag should be on the right for when you're coming in. Because that's how most people see it driving by. May not bug a lot of people, but it kind of bugs me. And even though I spent 16 years in the military, there are some times that I still have to look that up for protocol. Anyway, just gee whiz info for you. Oh, you thought you were going to try and pass me, huh? So we have a 6 hour run in game time.
Go straight.
20 minutes real world time, I guess, is what it says, which will probably end up being 30 minutes. Who knows? But then I thought we would take a run over to the new property I bought in Pecos. So not only you guys can see that, but I also haven't taken a really good look at it. I did, obviously, to make sure, you know, it loaded in the in fine and all that. So it should be a pretty chill episode. Fingers crossed.
Keep left. After 50 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Thank you. Also, as a reminder, in case you're not on Discord or don't see the community posts on YouTube, I will not be live on Saturday, the 12th. Need to catch up on some real life shit. Catch up slash take care of. But I will be live Sunday, the 12th. Didn't I just say Saturday the 12th? Saturday the 11th, I will not be live. But I will be live Sunday, the 12th. I really didn't pay attention when I picked up this load. There's a chance, depending on stoplights, we may be late. Or just regular AI traffic. Because there's only 9 hours and 44 minutes remaining on this load. Never mind, I'm an idiot again. I actually may adjust my sim dashboard because under time remaining for the load is next rest stop in. And then under that is the ETA. So I need to flip the next rest stop and time remaining lines. And then I shouldn't have this issue anymore. Then again, it is me, so there's a chance I could probably still have the issue. But it should minimize it, one would think. Why did I know that was going to happen? And now this car is going to speed up. Realized too, so I know the previous 5 drivers, so the ones that I before I just got hired in the last episode or prior to the last episode, I said I was leaving on balanced to see how they do. I totally forgot to change the new ones as well, so I may as well just leave those on balanced. And I may just take the time to go through every one of the drivers and do balance because I've got so many drivers now, it's a pain in the ass to keep going back and forth and seeing if they leveled up and where I need to move them to and all that other crap.
Keep right. After 50 yards, turn right.
honestly didn't mean to slow down that much, but I was looking in the mirrors and I got sidetracked because you can actually see the dunnage sticking out from the load. Which, as a ex-flatbed guy, is a damn nice touch. Straight piece of road. Yeah, see how the dunnage sticks out from the load? That's exactly how it would be. Even got the belly bands there. Well, not belly bands, but two straps over the bottom. Should technically be three straps over the top, but I'm not gonna go nuts over that. Sure, this is Bart's step deck. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you. Yeah, that's Bart's step deck. Again, for anyone wondering, I should remind people more often. I get bad at that, so apologies, but all my mods I'm running, link in the description to a Google Doc that I try and update regularly. There is this yard in Pecos may be in there. I can't remember. If not, there's two Matt VT yards that I need to put in there. Other than that, everything's the same. But it's not only the mods I'm running, it's the exact order I have them in. And then where I got them from. So if I got them from the Steam Workshop, obviously it says Steam Workshop. If I bought them from somewhere, the website's there. Or if it was free on a website, it's all there. As I've said before, I tried to make it army-proof. That bus driver, or waved and winked, wink wink, nudge nudge. He must have got the hint, though, because now I got over in the right lane. Like the Need for Speed bumper cam. Speed up over here. Okay, I don't see it in the bottom mirror. start taking the PVC pipe to the,
After 100 yards, turn left.
The wind turbine construction site.
Turn left.
It's off to the right. Okay. I mean, they have their telehandler right here. Like, why couldn't I just... kind of do one of these numbers. Just pull the brakes and unstrap and they can take it off. I know, overthinking it. Trailer. I'm gonna run into the same issue because the trailer apparently doesn't want to fucking bend. You know what? to start all the way back here just to get this to bend into there. I don't understand these trailers. Like, when you back them up fast like this, it will respond to how you want it to. So apparently on these step decks, I just need to back them up pissed off is basically what I'm gathering. And yes, before someone is thinking like, oh, well, it's a spread axle, it turns out, no shit. I mean, I guess I can see if there's anything going that way. Just for gee whiz. When I said that, it makes me think of Cheese Whiz. Now I'm hungry. Alright, so we're at Vestas. And there's one thing going to Albuquerque. Nothing going to Pecos, so you know what? We'll just do it on our dime. I think it's only 90 miles anyway, so we're good. Oh, I don't think I covered this up here. There's a Valentine event. 500,000 deliveries. Which the community will crush that. And then we do 14 personal deliveries. I don't know if I'll do those or not, because I really don't give a damn about the little Cupid thing you can hang in the truck and all that stuff. I may do one or two though, so y'all can see. This may work out well too, because there's a sleep trigger over there, I believe. That way it's daytime, we can actually see what we're trying to look at.
Yards, turn right. After 50 yards, exit right ahead. Exit right ahead.
We could just go in here and sleep. Probably get some fuel as well, by the looks of it. I don't see any decent specials. Night night. That's quick. I'm still kind of tired. One-lane road action. If memory serves me correctly, the name of this yard is Death Highway. I haven't researched it, but apparently this stretch of road is called Death Highway because, well, you can probably figure it out. Apparently it's dangerous. Oh, that's interesting. That's a... How you doing, sir? Hope you're having a wonderful day. the ranch. Look at that.
Keep left. After 50 yards, even a, turn left.
Even a truck wash right
turn
here.
Left.
So glad I can do this with this camera.
Turn left. Turn left.
No, I don't want to go to BP.
You have reached your destination.
Thank you. So this is it, folks. Already got the signs up. We don't waste any time. And as you can see by the trucks here, it's not only us that hauls out of here. But this is all shit show logistics now. I think the shop is over here. Don't hit the tanker. Oh, that's a sleep trigger. Yep. Shop right there. Fuel under the overhang, that's cool. Can sleep over here where the house is as well. But I'm assuming that's a house. It's probably where my property manager stays. So this is going to be part of I'm not going to change the sign or anything, but it's basically shit show logistics refinery or something like that. Tanker division, I don't know. See what we can get out of here. There may be, I honestly don't know if there's more. No, that seems to be the only loading trigger. Although there's another fuel spot over there to the left. And I'm assuming there's one out by BP too, which would make sense. But as for this, and I would assume that it's probably mainly fuel coming out of here. Okay, there is propane as well. And a backhoe. That's going to Wacko, that's going to Truckee. Beautiful. I wonder if anything is on the external market. No. That's the one thing about these yards like this, is that they typically have custom cargoes, or so they don't show up on the external market. Oh, that's kind of cool. Honestly, don't want to do any of those though, because we've already been to Truckee, right? And I'm pretty sure we've been to Price and we've been to Waco. Been to Truckee and to Price. And we've been to Waco. Alrighty. Well, let's just check the actual job market then. Oh, that's literally all that's coming out of here because it's... Okay, that makes sense. Man, that's a nice pay. All the way up to Bozeman. Have we been to LA? No, we haven't. That's interesting though. Okay, so probably what's gonna happen is this truck needs to get back up to Hell Creek, so I'm going to see if I have another driver in the area and basically send them back up with this truck and then take theirs. And then we will go from there. I would like to get over to Houston, but obviously I can't from there. But then again, all we did was buy the Houston garage. So, but anyway, that is the update. This is where 5 more drivers and 5 more trucks are going to go, and I just need to figure out how I want to configure the trucks. And that's basically where I'm at. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, episode 117 comes to an end. If you made it this far, I appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And don't forget to drop a like on the way out. And until the next one, y'all take care. Bye.